shit stains.
Oh.
Just sitting there with your eyes. Just, so yeah. What was it like working
so
on
Kira,
dick?
Can I ask you a question? I had so much coffee today.
Dude, what do you think? Right. These people leave, they're like, the fuck's up with those two guys, bro? They stink, the heavy breathers. Just in the mic the whole time.
I have to tell you, I don't think this chair was designed for this. I don't think it looks... Gotta look like a puppet, don't I? It hurts too. Not only is it cutting off the circulation, but it's kind of like jabbing into my bicep.
It looks like you're like in somebody else's shirt, and they're like dead, and their arms are just like,
their arms are my arms.
Do you remember that Halloween costume where the head would be like in the middle of the, like it would be on the plate, and there was like a headless guy up there? Yeah. Why'd you look at me like that?
I'm not looking at you, it's just my arms.
Yeah, okay, put them down. We have things to talk about.
Oh, welcome back for another... That's it. Welcome back for another.
That was really good.
Thanks, man.
You have notes?
I had a couple things that I wanted to talk about that I didn't address over the past couple weeks. You know, we've seen each other more this week than we did over the entire month of December, probably.
Well, yeah.
Well, yeah. I can't wait for you guys to see the outro that we haven't filmed yet.
It's so stupid. Because it's like, to the average viewer, they're like, why would they shoot the outro first?
Makes no sense.
What a waste of time.
They haven't experienced anything yet. It's like shooting a movie out of order. They don't do that. They shoot it in order.
Thanks. Dennis, I went to thanks for cutting me for that. Blah, blah, blah. They're going to want to see that.
I went to the Rockettes show. In New York. He does a Broadway show. It's pretty cool. He just goes on stage and does that for an hour. And my girlfriend wanted to go because...
You have a girlfriend?
No.
That's awesome, dude.
Thanks. So does Dennis. What about you?
Hey, Dennis. Go ahead.
Her mom wanted to see the Rockettes. I don't know if it was, you know, like, my childhood. Or it's like, oh, it's a cute show. So they did, like, this Christmas Rockettes, and they do this thing, you know?
Yeah.
It was horrible. It was awful. And not because it wasn't, they didn't do a good job, but because I'm not 6 years old. And it's very Christmas-themed. So if you're super into like Christmas and trees and the presents and the snow and all that, like,
is it on Broadway?
Yeah, I mean it was on Broadway.
It's still fun to go see a Broadway show.
We got to go to Radio City. It was at Radio City, and that was pretty cool. I've never been in there. That's a really cool. I can't believe John Mulaney sold out that arena. Yeah, or center or whatever
place.
It is, huh?
Place.
I just don't think it's kind of like going back and watching
Bro, hang on. I just had this insane image because there's so much noise happening over here.
I just get
the audience
blasted.
Just a fucking car comes through.
You're scarred, man.
Shoves you so far across the room.
If you get lucky enough to not get killed by the same car, Dennis and I are gone, man. You're doing your own podcast.
You know, it's like you ever have like those such vivid images of it, like it happened in front of me. I was looking at you and I pictured you just flying.
I'm just talking to you for 1 second. The next second, I'm in the other
Toyota
room.
Corolla just fucking shoves
my
you.
Bottom half is still right here.
What is the car only take out your head?
Yeah, man, it's like your car. You know, the whole like the front end went low. This one goes high. Just
right,
takes
so what
torso.
The fuck were you saying? It's
I don't
nonsense.
Know. I can't do it, man. I can't do the Rockettes. Tell you what, though, I caught one of the like at the end of the show. They shot off like streamers, and then they were coming down. All the kids were like screaming, grabbing for them, tearing each other's limbs off.
Bunch of kids.
Give me their fucking streamers, kids. Speaking of which, though, I did grab one. This girl had a hand on it, and I was like, I'm gonna get. I saw this other girl next to me like reaching for one, and I was like, I'm gonna get it, this long piece. I just like grabbed it and like ripped off a piece before this other girl could grab it, so it was shorter. And then I was like, here you go, kiddo. Here's this fucking streamer you're gonna throw away when you get home. But then she tied it to a little teddy bear. It was a cute moment. So at least I got to take that home. That was nice.
Stop cutting to me when I'm coughing, dude. It's just every. It's like you're predicting my coughs too, because it's the start of it. Every time I look up at the screen, I'm like,
just don't. We're turning this off next time, so you can't see. Bro, it.
So I was driving to the gym this morning. All right.
So I bought us tickets to the Rockettes. They're coming to LA. They're doing a world tour. So
yeah, great. So I was driving to the gym at 6 a.m. this morning. And some guy was like,
I can't believe you saw a rocket.
Shut up, dude. Some guy started like brake checking some dude, okay? He said, at 6 a.m., right? Stop.
You never heard of brake checking, dude?
Kids are, you know, there's audio listeners too. We'll have no idea what you
in case you missed that, audio listeners. I was brake checking Bradley.
That's brake dancing, dude.
No, dude. It's called the brake check now.
And so the guy behind him swerves to the right, floors it, gets in front of him, and slams on his brakes. So the guy behind him then had to slam on his brakes and swerve out of the way. This was at 6 in the morning. And I thought, like, there's nobody on the road. How can you be this fucking pissed at this one dude at this early in the morning? Like, I'm driving to the gym, and I'm just like, you know, I'm tired, I'm comfortable, I'm in the car, and I'm just cruising. These fucking guys are, like, going at it. Like,
How did he instigate it?
That's what I'm saying, was there was, like, one dude in the fast lane, and he started brake checking the guy behind him.
For what?
Because he was too close to him. He was annoyed. But
that's a,
like,
good idea. That's always a good idea.
It makes no sense. But also, like, why didn't the guy go? There was nobody on the road, bro. Like, it was me and those two cars. So why didn't he just go around him?
Oh, instead of, like, sitting on his ass?
Yeah, it's like, it was pointless. But then they're all pissed at each other. And I'm like, how are
they're
you
taking
doing
turns
this?
Going around, brake checking, then going around.
It's 6 o'clock in the morning. Like, it's so ridiculous. But then it made me think about it. And the reason I wrote this down was, did you ever hear the story of the guy who drove like 400 miles to kill his girlfriend because she was cheating on him?
No.
In like a different state? How pissed do you have to be?
For 7 hours, 8 hours in the car?
That long, listening to podcasts, just fucking furious, dude.
He's listening to motivational podcasts. You can do it, all right? Seriously,
stop,
don't give up on your dream.
Fuck. Keeps doing that. Anyway, I just made me think about it this morning. I was thinking about, I've never been so pissed that I drove for 8 hours and I'm still pissed, dude.
That's too long to be. I mean, sure, you can be angry about it, but that's too long to sit there and not try to understand before you go.
Should
murder.
I do this?
Yeah.
Is it considered premeditated? But you could be like, sir, I got in the car immediately. I was pissed.
No, like, where'd you drive to? You're like, oh, Delaware. What do you mean?
Saskatchewan.
Yeah.
For future listeners.
I had a joke and I lost it. Oh, man.
It probably wasn't funny.
It was funny.
This one's like...
Wait, I think I remember it.
Hi,
no,
Steven. Oh, this is to my account. Sorry.
You're joking. You wrote in your podcast notes a note to your account.
Hope you enjoyed the holidays. Anyway.
Go
ahead.
Oh,
now.
I got it. Oh, you said something about premeditated murder. That's what that's what reminded me of it. Man. Do you have like horrible memory problems?
Nope, just you.
My life is collapsing around me.
Do you want me to tell a different thing?
Huh?
Do you want me to say something else while you think?
No, I lost it because you had to cough and get camera time.
Yeah, you took my camera time because you coughed.
That made me lose my train of thought.
I had this thought the other day, profound, that golf is a lot like life and relationships. And you should reflect on your round and think about your ways of getting better. And if you...
Were you driving when you wrote this down?
No. What?
I feel like that's something you would do.
And if you cheat your way through it...
You're only cheating yourself.
And you're never going to get better.
You're never going to succeed in life. You're never going to get better at golf if you're the guy who's kicking the ball out from under the tree or going, well, I took them all again, but I still got a par. If you're that guy, you're not going to get better. You're not going to grow. You know?
It's very wise.
Yeah. It was a shower thought.
Ah.
Yeah. I was really doing some comparisons because I was thinking about my last round of golf pre-accident.
Wait, was that with the Pointer Brothers?
When I played with them?
Well, yeah, was that your last round or no?
No, I played Westlake one time with Zach.
With me?
Maybe.
Oh, yeah, I think so. Yeah, oh, my God, I played so bad. I played so horrible.
That's how addicted to golf I am, dude. I'm sitting here thinking about it because I can't play it. Yeah. I'm thinking about my last round of golf and going through every shot I hit. Our viewers don't care about that.
Nope. I played so much golf last year.
I know.
You know, your Gin app has a summary of like how many rounds you played in 1 year.
How many did you have?
Oh, man, I probably had over 100.
Wow.
That I logged.
Yeah, so easily.
Something close to it.
Way more. Easily.
Probably.
Easily way more.
Easily
very
way more.
Profound thing.
Which is every 3 days I played golf.
Hey, have you seen any movies recently? I feel like movies are kind of back, you know?
Yeah.
Like people are like really into
Barbenheimer.
Movies right now. You think that's what kicked it off?
I thought they got an award at the something
Sag
for
Wars.
Like bringing people back to cinema. Basically yep. Reigniting theaters.
Yeah, I was scratching my nose, Dennis. If you could cut to me for that, that'd be great.
I think they got so many X amount of, obviously hundreds and hundreds of millions, a billion dollars, whatever.
Hundreds of billions.
Hundreds of billions. So many billions of dollars. But they, I mean, after that, I think I went to theaters like three more times that month. And honestly, I'd been going to theaters like once every 4-5 months.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, there's certain movies that like, you're like, dude, I got to see that in theaters, you know? Like, and I want to be in with the people who are also going to the theaters. It makes it a little more fun.
No, well, yeah, and I forgot how much I liked the experience of movie theaters. Yeah,
I love movies. It's such a great experience. It makes everything funnier when you're actually there because you hear other people laugh and you're laughing. It's weird to laugh out loud when you're home by yourself watching a movie.
Yeah.
You know, something about it feels weird. But
that's
when you're
right.
In a theater, it's like, it's fun. It's all part of it.
You know? Someone was talking about a movie they saw the other day, and they were like, yeah, watching that in the theater totally changed all those.
Look what just popped up on my watch.
Why did I pop up on that?
You can't see it, audience, but it's just a photo of Jake Short.
Wait.
It's from the Sit and Chat Instagram account.
I didn't share a post, did I?
Maybe.
Oh. We shared
two
photos?
Well, anyway, we have a new Sit and Chat Instagram account. We're going to be posting a lot of clips on that.
Yeah, we're just going to post clips there.
Yeah. So it's a place for people to go see clips from the episodes. Maybe get some new audience members.
No, I don't. I like all our audience now. If any new audience members come in, I'm going to block them. I'm going to block all of them.
Yeah. Well, I was hoping to buy a home soon.
With what? Bitcoin.
Do you have any Bitcoin?
I do not. Do you have any Bitcoin?
No.
Cool.
I never mind. I was going to share a story and I don't want to.
Can I share one more story? Oh, did we talk about this? How you stay up before flights? I feel like we did talk about
that. Yeah, on last week's episode.
Oh, no. We talked about it.
Oh,
in the
on
solo.
The episode that you refused to air. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Bradley wants to do a solo episode and I don't want to do one because I like having guests. I like having little people pop in, hearing about their
lives.
How about
if we get more than 100 comments on this video of people saying release a solo episode?
No.
You'll release it.
How about as soon as we get to 50,000 subscribers, I will release
it. It was
solo.
A funny episode, too.
What?
It was a funny episode.
No, it was not.
Yeah, it was.
All you did was not avoid talking about Sabrina.
What's wrong with you?
I don't know, man. I'm just putting it out there. I think you had to go and you had to go on TikTok and comment. Had to go set the record straight.
I was trying to clear my name.
You didn't have to.
I'm a good person.
You could do it right here. Do it right here.
I'm a good person. And I didn't do anything wrong. So I wanted to clarify and say that I'm a good person.
I think you're a good person.
I'd like to believe so. I think so.
Jury's still out, but.
My point was, and I know that you're like, don't reply to people, but because those were your exact words. And I think I
said that.
I think I hung up and went, boop, 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 boop. I was like, yeah, yeah, bro, I got you. I'm not going to reply. I said, I definitely won't do that.
I definitely won't do that. Oh, we're going to get the Pointer Brothers on here, too.
Dude, we should record an episode with them, like, tomorrow at 10.
9:15. hey, but before we do that, we should record an episode with Kira, who was nice enough to drive to us on 1521, whatever that person said. and record an episode today. Outro. So let's go snag her and
Kira Kosarin.
Make some magic.
From the Thundermans.
Thundermans. Yeah. Soon to be Thundermans movie.
Come on down. Oh, she's not here. Okay.
Hey, hello. Welcome back once again. We're eight in now. Very exciting. Eight episodes down. Yes. Kira Hi. Is here with us. Thank you so much for coming and joining us
Thanks
today.
Thanks for having me.
Did you know that most podcasts don't make it to 10 episodes?
Yep. Is that a true fact?
It's like 95% of podcasts don't make it to 10. So
hopefully today you'll say something.
You may beat the statistics. Who's
yeah.
to say?
Yeah, we want to get canceled after this. So you guys can help us out.
As a podcaster, as people. Because I can make you get canceled if you want.
Do it. Yeah, I'm sure you could. We need press. All presses.
I do have the power to do that. Yeah. Cool.
No, we have to film two tomorrow, and that'll be 10.
Exciting. You going to do anything to celebrate?
We don't know if we're going to do another one, though.
I think I'm going to move away, so we can't do another one. Yeah, I think that's how I'm going to celebrate.
That's fair.
Yeah, I like to be a part of statistics. But thank you for coming in today.
Yeah. For those out there watching, you might know Kira from the Thundermans, her music, and some other things that we're going to have her plug right now because I can only do so much on Wikipedia, which is how I do my research.
That's the best form of research.
Yeah, really no, is. That's you about covered it. Yeah, those are the big ones and, you know, some dark corners of the internet.
Yeah.
Just TikTok.
Well, our first guest was actually Mr. Jack Griffo.
Was it?
Yeah.
Sorry, who's that?
Your brother,
who?
I think.
Yeah. Never...
Played your brother.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, sounds familiar. So, that's cool. How's that?
It's fun. Jack can talk. Which is nice, you know?
Yeah.
It makes podcasting so much easier.
And that was our first episode back after like an 8-month hiatus. So it was pretty easy.
Yeah.
And but, I think he was just starting his tour. So he was really excited to.
Nice.
Well, we talked with him for a minute, but you guys had just finished the movie.
Yeah.
Which he couldn't talk about?
Yeah.
At the time, because we were on strike.
It was strike times.
Yeah.
We shot the movie in April of last year, and it's coming out in March of this year.
Did you guys film it in LA?
Yeah, we filmed it at Paramount.
Oh, nice. Oh,
we weren't awesome. Able to get our old stage. Stage 25 was still being used by iCarly, or at least the sets were still in there because they were waiting to find out if they were going to get another season or
Did
not.
Did they go again? Huh? No. Did they? Are they continuing?
No, they're done. They ended on a cliffhanger.
Wow, what a weird, like,
sucks. Dude.
2013, like, little throwback.
Time warp, I know.
Like, Thundermans went back to iCarly.
It was super weird. It was like... The Paramount was almost a ghost town because it was also still like COVID era. We all had to do masks and testing everything. So it was us. We shared a wall. Like our soundstage was one of those like double sound stages, and the other one was the Frasier reboot.
Mm-hmm.
So we kept like accidentally walking onto the Frasier set. So it was like
was
Frasier.
There any new shows?
Yeah, no, literally. I was like, okay, what year is it?
Yeah.
It's certainly not 2023. Yeah, Frasier, us, iCarly, and I think that might have been it. It was like a ghost town at Paramount. But it was really nice to be back.
Isn't Frasier already a spinoff of Cheers?
Yes.
Yes.
So they went Cheers, Frasier.
Kelsey Grammer is the longest running single character played by an actor in history because he played his character on Cheers and then on Frasier and now
and
on
now
the
still,
reboot.
Yeah. Yeah, because I think the only person
like 40
could,
years of one
yeah,
character.
You get to use that? Yeah.
The only like person who would probably even come close would be like, my first thought was when... Matt LeBlanc did the Joey spinoff.
Oh,
but that
yeah.
was not the same character.
Yeah, he went and did, went and did Joey.
But, oh, I forgot about that. See, I
remember?
Loved Episodes dearly, his other show. Oh, I watched it like seven times.
I loved
times.
That show.
But I don't think I ever watched Joey.
Yeah,
it was department.
Right after Friends. Like,
yeah, I think our Thundermans wardrobe department worked on Joey.
Yeah,
I remember seeing like continuity
moved
photos.
To Los Angeles
right.
was like the story. I don't think it did very well.
I don't think
no,
it did very well.
But
at
Episodes
all.
Was fabulous. So.
Episodes was great because Episodes was like, Matt LeBlanc making fun of Matt LeBlanc.
Yeah,
which
is always,
awesome.
I love when somebody plays like a fictionalized asshole version of themselves.
Yeah, I know. They did it in such a good way too, because it wasn't like, you weren't like, oh, this guy's just gross and I hate him.
He's very
endearing.
Like,
it was very endearing.
He's a lovable asshole.
Yeah.
And the best characters often are.
And you kind of felt like this is what like Joey as a person would be like, you know, that was my feeling.
Lovable asshole.
You weren't that big of a Friends fan.
You weren't that big of a lovable asshole.
I know. Not the lovable part.
Not a Friends fan?
I like Friends. I really can't stand the last like two seasons. It's really hard for me to get through.
You know, any sitcom that goes past 5 or 6 years, I'm like, power to you for even coming up with ideas. Because yeah. I remember by 100th episode, you're like, what are we even doing here anymore? Yeah. Like, what is this show about at this point?
So how many episodes have they done?
Did you guys do?
107? It's 106?
Damn it. You beat Good Luck Charlie by 6.
Sorry. Yeah, we were the number one longest running, and then Henry Danger beat us, so we're also not the winners.
How many did they do?
Like 112. It wasn't that many more. Yeah. Just enough more to get the title, but then they also had the spinoff, which is happening now.
Mm. So, oh, is he still doing
it? Yeah, I don't know if Jace is still in it or not.
Everything's a spinoff.
Everything's a spinoff. I know. Yeah.
How do you feel about that? Because everything is a spinoff.
Saddened. Yeah. I mean, look, as you do, I'm sure.
Capitalizing off nostalgia?
Yeah, Yes.
Welcome to the podcast.
Exactly, yes. Hi.
Let's sit and chat about it.
I appreciate the power of nostalgia. I do think it's sad because like original ideas are great, but I also kind of get it. Like we live in the future. Everything's kind of been done. Like there are still original ideas left, but I see why it would be an easy grab for a network or a high up to just go, let's just do what's worked.
It's getting confusing though, because I do feel like people, like the general audience is like, all right, I'm over it. Like,
yeah, 100%.
Start giving me new stuff.
100%. You know? Well, especially because like, I think a lot of the things that are being rebooted, like they were really situated in a certain time and place. Yeah. And when you extract them from that time and place, they don't make sense in the same way. Like shows in the 90s were, even if they weren't about life in the 90s, they were about life in the 90s. And when you pick them up and you plop them into now, like it doesn't really make sense. Like I was seeing people talk about that with Mean Girls, which I haven't seen yet. But like Mean Girls is such an early 2000s piece of like iconic pop culture.
Yeah.
To pick up a story like that and move it to like, we're all going to make jokes about TikTok now. Like makes me sad. And again, I haven't seen it. It could be wonderful. And I love Renee Rapp till I die. But like, it's just, it's sad.
Yeah. And I feel like also too, with like some of like the kids stuff, like things that you watched as a kid worked because you were a kid.
Right.
But if I go and watch it as an adult, it doesn't have the same feeling.
It's that being said, please watch the Thundermans movie.
Except for the Thundermans. Well, I was actually about to say.
No, it's funny. It's funny that you say that, because when the idea was brought to me to do more with Thundermans, I was really, really reluctant at first. Yeah, I said no multiple times because I was like, I love this thing that we made. I'm really proud of it. It was a good 6 years. Like we did it. We did the damn thing. I don't want to open that door and like ruin the legacy, basically. But you know, they really wanted to do something with it, and after I thought about it long enough, I was like, okay, if we're gonna do this, I feel very strongly about how it should be done. And that was how I ended up as an executive producer, was because I was like, it needs to be this, these people need to work on it, otherwise it's not gonna feel right. Like this is where the genre needs to sit, we need a rework of the script. Like that was how I got in, because I was like, I am really scared to mess this up.
The same creators that wrote the movie?
It's the original show creator.
Okay.
Yeah.
And did he bring it to you, or did Paramount bring it to you as like a package? Or?
No. See, this is where I don't know what I am like
allowed to say?
Talk about. Yeah. I think I'd say it came from a different place than the creator of the show, which already I was like, what?
Yeah. But the creator
from other people who had been involved with the show, who had an idea, but it wasn't the show's original creator.
And the creator ended up writing it.
We met, and I was like, "How can we make this feel like the show?"
And of you're doing it, and I'm doing it if you're doing it.
Exactly, exactly. And like it was really important to me that we had a certain director who I felt like really got the humor of the show, and like I really wanted to try to make sure he was there. And like you know, I thought it was really important that the wardrobe department came back, because the costumes and the super suits were like such a big part of the show's like visual look, and having that original team there to update was really important. And
I have like three questions on that.
Yeah.
First question, when did you guys finish the series? What year was that?
We wrapped in, it'll be 7 years ago summer. So it was, we wrapped in like May, 2017. And then the finale aired, I think, in 2018.
Yeah. So, I mean, that it's not like it's been that long.
No.
To where it's almost not nostalgia at a certain point. You know what I mean?
Yeah. So that's the other thing that was a lot of discussions at the beginning of figuring out what the project would look like, was that we're not far enough away for it to have been an iCarly reboot.
Like a reboot.
Yeah. Well, it's not like an all grown up, now we're raunchy and making dirty jokes and cursing. It's like, and especially because we were in a really weird position where like the show ended and then was quiet for a minute. And then in 2021, during COVID, the show went number three on Netflix. It had this like random resurgence because kids were watching it during the pandemic. And so,
and you guys made so much money from that, right?
Yeah. Not a cent. Not a single residual check. Although my parents do get residual checks for their guest stars, but that's another story.
Love that.
Which I always think is funny that they do and I don't.
My mom was on Good Luck Charlie.
Was
too.
She?
Yeah, she did an episode.
That's really She's sweet.
She played my mom in like a commercial that I was in.
You know that your TV dad played my TV boyfriend's father. Yeah, Do you know about this?
No.
Yeah, Eric was on the Thundermans.
Yeah, he was on it a couple of times. It was really fun. Yeah. He played like the scary supervillain father of the boy I like. Classic. Of course. And my dad's like nemesis. He was great. He owned a mattress shop.
Saw him today. He's amazing. He's just so vibrant.
I haven't seen him in a while. Yeah. Anyway, we were in a really weird place where we were like, okay, we've got 20 to 25 year old fans who watch the original show and we don't want it to feel too childish. We want them to like enjoy it. But there's also like new 6 to 10 year olds who have just discovered the show who don't even know that 6 years have passed since it ended and 11 or whatever since it started. So like coming up with a way to make them all happy was a really big goal. I think we treaded that line really well.
Yeah.
I mean, we'll see when it comes out. But
I mean, that's impressive, a feat in itself, because I think back to like, you ever get recognized by like a 12-year-old and you go, you're too young to have watched Mind Event. Mind Event ended like 8 or 9 years ago.
Dude,
But streaming and...
And streaming and the kids, they have older
siblings.
And if you can attach those two audiences, it's super impressive.
Yeah. I did have, for the first time recently, I had a fan of the show who had a kid who was showing her kid the show. And I was like, how is that possible?
That's
she
terrifying.
Was like 15 when she watched it. She's 26 now and she has a 4-year-old.
Yep.
And I was like, oh yeah, I guess that's a thing.
That's possible.
And you guys are watchable. You're on. It's safe enough for kids to get on board. It's, I mean, not...
Question two.
So I'm just kidding. We're just going to keep interrupting you and changing the subject.
Can I just put them on my notes real quick, Bradley?
Yeah, yeah. So the second question was, did you guys film outside at all or was it all on the stage?
For the movie or the original series?
For the movie.
We filmed outside for the movie. There's a really big, like, 3-minute cold open. There's a brief moment of it in the teaser that they just released. It was very different than anything we've done before. We also, there's a couple. There's like the cold open and then there's, I think, two other scenes on the Paramount backlot.
Yeah. So the reason I ask for general audience is usually if you film on a soundstage for a TV show, you never go outside.
No, literally never. I mean, Hannah Montana was like a beach set.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I think when people see the photos of that, it like breaks their brain a little bit.
So it's like really not common. But, and then so the director, the last question was the director that directed a bunch of the show.
He directed a bunch of Thundermans. He had directed like, I'm going to get this wrong, but out of 100 and something episodes, he probably did like 13 or 14 or something, which is like a lot.
Who was it?
Trevor Kirshner.
Name sounds familiar.
Does sound familiar. I don't think he's
awesome. He's been like a really wonderful sort of mentor too. He's taught me a lot about directing. He's great.
Yeah. So the reason I asked that question is because it's also super rare for a TV show director to direct film. I feel like sitcom directors very rarely direct
film. I don't know if it would have gone that way if I hadn't put my foot down so hard about this being a sitcom movie.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it's not a gritty single cam because, first of all, I was like, I don't want to go to Canada and shoot a gritty single cam for 6 weeks. Like, that's just not fun for me. I love multicam so dearly and it just doesn't exist in the industry anymore.
No.
Like, there is no adult sitcom. The only way you can do multi is to do Nick or Disney. Mm-hmm. So I was like, if I'm going to come back to Nickelodeon and do something Thundermans, like, I want to do a multicam. And I also think that when you take a show with a laugh track and you take the laugh track out of it, it just like sucks all the energy out of it. And you start to go, was this ever
funny? You guys had a laugh track in it?
Yeah.
That's cool. That's really cool.
I made sure of it. I was like, this needs a laugh track because otherwise people are going to retroactively think the show was never funny.
Yeah.
Because that's what happens when you take a laugh track out. Sometimes it works. Like, I think it worked for one of the Wizards movies. It's like, if you want to go really dark and serious with it. But
I
didn't want to go dark and serious. So it is it's a sitcom. It's a hybrid. It's a multi. And we shot it with a really weird multi-hybrid schedule. So we shot for 4 weeks, but we rehearsed Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, filmed Thursday, Friday, just like the old days. So we only had 9 shoot days for the entire movie, which was not quite enough, but we made it work.
Yeah, that's like impossibly low.
It was crazy.
And that was, is that the first thing that you produced?
Yeah.
That was fun. That's a big.
It was, you know, it was interesting. I was really, at first I was like, oh God, executive producer is like a big job and a big title and a big, like, I had like an office in the production office, like building, like where I used to go for casting. Mm-hmm. And I was really nervous. And then once I started working on it, I realized like any gaps that I had in my producerial knowledge or like any inexperience there was kind of filled in by my knowledge and experience of the show itself.
Yeah.
Like, had I been executive producing like a Good Luck Charlie movie for the first time ever, I would have been like, okay, I think I know, yeah. But like I know the Thundermans universe inside and out. So when it came to like designing wardrobe or like making set deck changes or like casting, I was like, okay, yeah, I know how to do this. Like I know this world. So it was a good confidence builder. Really fucking hard to do both at the same time though, being off camera and on camera.
Yeah.
It's long days.
Doesn't that make you look at like Bradley Cooper with Maestro having written it, directed it, and like, how do you do that?
The big one that I've been thinking about a lot is Margot Robbie doing Barbie.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Because she's such an involved producer. I mean, everything that Lucky Chap does, I think she's incredibly involved in, but like to take on that kind of a role and be so involved in every single thing about the project is just like absolutely incredible. She's mind blowing.
So you guys got lucky. The writer on the Good Luck Charlie movie wasn't one of our writers. It was just a feature film writer.
Yeah.
So they had hired the guy. And it's not that he did a bad job.
Which,
first
of all, good for him. That's very impressive to like write a spec movie script and like get it made.
Especially at that point.
For a series
like,
you're not part of.
For a show that was established and doing well. And then to come on and have to write a movie about it. It was just kind of like our concern was that it was like, well, you guys, he doesn't really know our characters.
Yeah.
You know? So it kind of felt like a generic version of it.
What was the timing of that? Was it during the main series or was it years later?
Dude, so we shot...
Was that after second season?
No, it was in between second season. We shot 15 episodes, went to Utah, filmed the movie, came back and
Utah?
And then did 15 more episodes.
Why Utah?
Dude, there's so much shooting in Utah now.
Wow.
Shot in
Disney
Salt Lake.
Moved to Utah right after we stopped working on it. They moved a bunch of their production to Utah. I don't know if it was the sound stages were cheaper or the tax breaks, but...
Yeah,
probably
it makes
the tax
sense.
Breaks.
Yeah, it's cheap
always,
for movies.
It's always the tax breaks.
It's super cheap for movies, but we also, I think the story, I can honestly say I haven't seen that movie in 10 years, but.
So I think it was during the original run?
Yeah. It was in the middle of our second season.
We
had to be in like Palm Springs for like the bit, and then the girls were in Vegas. So they kind of felt like it was the best of both worlds on that.
Yeah.
It had kind of a similar vibe.
That's funny.
So that's why we ended up in Utah.
We shot at the end of I genuinely don't remember if it was the end of the third season or the fourth season. We shot a movie and it was like a single cam.
Yeah.
I think it might have, did it? I don't even remember if it had electric, but it was supposed to be in Hawaii. It was called Thunder in Paradise. And they told us we were going to go to Hawaii and we were so excited. And then like 3 weeks before production, they were like, actually, we're shooting in Malibu. And we were like, all right, Malibu's still cool, but like, damn it. And it also meant we had to get up at like 2 a.m. to get to Malibu by 5 to get through hair and makeup to film on the beach by 7:30. Cause they had like rented out little Paradise Cove for like early in the morning.
Bro, even worse, so we had an episode of Good Luck Charlie that was the family goes to Hawaii.
Yeah. And, so it's the classic
it's
sitcom
the classic.
Format.
Yeah, the only difference is Modern Family had also just filmed an episode, but they all went and filmed in Maui.
So we were
on our soundstage pretending to be there.
It's so funny that you just brought up Modern Family because I literally mentioned this in one of the other podcasts that I did this week, which is that it was always such a weird feeling when we would go to all of the like young Hollywood events and it would be like the Nickelodeon stars, the Disney stars, and the Modern Family cast.
Yeah.
And like the red carpet people didn't give a fuck about us and they were so excited about the Modern Family kids. And I just remember being like, I wish I was on a network show. Yeah. Like, come on.
For a lot of reasons. Yeah. For a lot of reasons, I wish I was on a network show.
Enough of that.
Thank you, Nickelodeon.
Let's go back in time a little bit.
To those young Hollywood events?
No. Let's go back in time.
Let's not go back to those.
The stars, the cameras, the flashes.
Jake, you did your
research.
The
trampolines.
Where's she from?
You're from New Jersey.
I am from New Jersey.
Yeah.
Well researched.
So... Born in New Jersey.
Saskatchewan, New Jersey. I don't know the city.
Not Saskatchewan. It's Saskatchewan.
It's in Canada.
Canada.
It's in Canada.
I'm from Saskatchewan, New Jersey. No, so my family's from New York, first and foremost. So like, I feel like I'm from New York, but my parents just didn't want to raise me in the city. So I was born in New Jersey, like 45 minutes outside of Manhattan. And then we moved when my dad like quit the Broadway biz. My mom retired. Sorry, my mom retired from Broadway when I was like 6 because the schedule is just like insane to try to do at the same time as being a mom. And so my dad was like, okay, I'm going to leave the industry and like go just like find a job to support the family, whatever. And that moved us to Florida. So we lived in Florida from when I was like 7. And then I moved out here when I was 12, right before I turned 13.
Was it to?
Yeah.
No, you got this one.
Was it to pursue acting or was
it
because?
Yeah, it was. I had met an acting teacher in Florida who had been on Disney a long time ago and was like going around teaching classes.
Oh, I love those people.
Yeah, classic. Yeah. And
let me tell you, it's better to executive produce than to go back and teach those classes. Very sweet people, but it definitely is.
Look, this person completely changed my life. Like, I wouldn't be here without him. So he made a big impact on me and a lot of other people. But Yeah, I took these classes and I came out to LA for like an acting class workshop, and I met some agents and stuff, and they were like, when are you moving here? And I was like, what?
Tomorrow,
yeah. And at that point, I mean, you remember how it used to be. You had to like come out for pilot season and go to the auditions. Like, you couldn't just send in self-tapes. It didn't like work that way. So came out for what was going to be a semester and just like started auditioning, and then we just never went home. My mom went home and sold the house in Florida, packed it up for us because I was like auditioning and going to school and taking classes and stuff, and we just stayed here.
That's wow.
Yeah. So your family was in the industry. That's kind of like a rarity. Yeah, I feel like I rarely meet people.
So they were in an industry. They weren't quite in this industry, which I think was pros and cons. They were not stage parents. Like, they really did not force me into the industry at all.
No, they're like, if you want to do it, do it.
Yeah, they had done Broadway, and they had seen a lot of kids grow up doing 8 shows a week and knew it was a really hard life. And so they did not like encourage me to go into it, but...
Those kids, I think, get less of an education than I did.
It's a hard existence. Yeah. And a lot of, it's a hard existence. So it wasn't until, you know, they encouraged me to dance and take classes and sing and like all of that, do all the creative stuff of it.
Express yourself.
Yeah, none of the industry stuff. And it wasn't until I started to get serious about like, no, I really want to do this. They're like, okay, if you're going to put in the work and like stay grounded and keep going to school and all that, then we'll support it. So yeah, we moved out here, and I was very lucky that I was able to have both of my parents move out here with me, because as I'm sure you guys have seen, like a lot of kids move out here with one parent and that ends up in divorce. It's like a hard thing to see happen. Or like the siblings have to get separated or.
Yeah, I didn't see I saw my siblings for summers like.
Yeah.
During the year. That was pretty much it.
It's really, so I was really lucky, just pure luck, that I was an only child, and my dad had had this crazy freak accident and had to stop working, and my mom was still retired, and so we had nothing keeping us in Florida. So my parents were like, well, why not? Let's try it. Let's go to California for 6 months. They also like had a pair of friends who lived here who they love, and they're like, all right, we've got some friends there, like the weather's nice, go try it for a while.
So there's a bit of a stereotype behind only children. Do you feel like you exhibit any of those stereotypes?
I mean, reluctantly, I think I have to say yes. Yeah. I will say, I think a lot of the things I like about myself are because I'm an only child. Like, I'm very comfortable alone. Like, I feel like I know myself really well, and I'm very like happy in my own company, and I get a lot out of my like alone time. I think I definitely used to be a little bit more of a control freak because of it, because I was never like forced to share my toys at 5 years old. Yeah. But I don't know. I mean, I've never known anything else. Are you an only child?
No, I have three sisters.
Quite
the contrary.
Are you like very protective of them? Or are they older or younger?
They're all older.
Oh, so you're the baby boy. Yeah, yeah.
So I'm the baby boy.
His hand-me-downs are dresses. He looks good though.
My growing up was very different because I got, you know, kind of the opposite of what I feel like most brothers like, because you have younger sisters, right? So you're protective of your younger sisters. There was nothing.
You're both one boy with sisters?
I have an older brother. You have brothers, yeah.
God, big families. Yeah, yeah. But I've said this to him the other day. It's like, I don't think my sisters opened a door for like the first 12 years of my life, you know? Because like they would just always like pushing like gentleman manners. Like, those are the things that you should do for a girl. So I feel like I was very trained for girlfriends. By the time I had my first one, I was trained.
Like, as a girl, like if you meet a guy, if you're on a date with a guy and you find out that they've got like multiple sisters, it's like a kind of a green flag instantly, because you're like, okay, they know how to like.
I feel that way with girls too, though. I don't know. Sometimes if like a girl's like, I have older brothers, I'm like, I don't want to deal with older brothers.
No, that's very different.
That's scary, you know?
Hold on though. I would purposefully go in the door before, hold the door open, and then shut the door and lock the door. Because
they were younger, sisters, though.
Yeah, because they're younger.
Well, the power imbalance. Control.
The power imbalance.
Because my oldest sister's 8 years older than me, so that's a big difference.
Yeah.
It's weird now, too, because
she's almost retired now, isn't she?
Yeah. She's just retired.
She's fucking old.
She passed away of natural causes.
Lived a good long life. 30.
But they all have, like, my two oldest sisters have kids now.
I was about to ask, are you an uncle?
Yeah, one sister has 3 kids, the other one has 1.
That's wild. We just had, I told you I couldn't get words out today. I just had my first friend have a baby, and it's a really bizarre thing, because I've had like friends of friends and like my parents' friends, but this is the first time that's like my friends.
It's technically like an aunt, you know? Kind of.
They called me Auntie Kira. I held him for the first time a few weeks ago. It was very sweet.
Oh, I saw that picture. Yeah.
And all the comments were like, is your baby? Yeah. Is you baby?
You have one
you
now?
You have baby? It's like, no, it's not my baby.
That's.
I will not be having a baby for a minute.
Yeah.
Yeah. No.
10 years minimum.
Really?
Yeah.
Dude, I want to have a kid by 30.
Really?
Yeah. Dude, he talked.
You don't
about
have
it
to
like...
have it in your body.
No, I want to produce the thing that allows me to have a kid.
Well,
by
that's
30.
The easy part.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. I'll do the easy one.
You
yeah,
want the few minutes part. Of effort and then the 18 years.
Yeah. My fiance was like, he's like, I would carry it if I could, and I know he would, and he would do a great job. So I'm just like, maybe if I wait 10 years, science will get to a point where he can carry it.
When is the date?
That'd be pretty cool. Could you imagine?
Of
Your wedding.
Of the baby.
Yes, of the baby. So yes. Of course you can predict
we're
that.
We're not 100% sure.
100% sure.
Congrats on the engagement.
Thank
congrats.
You. Thank
that was
you,
very
yeah.
cute engagement.
Thank you. Yeah. It was a very special trip.
Did you know, feel any of it coming?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was going to ask.
Oh, you 100%.
Knew. He knew I wanted to know a little bit. Like, I didn't want to be fully surprised. I wanted to know to blow dry my hair that morning. You know what I mean? Like, when you're on vacation and you're drinking every night and you're having fun, like, I was just like, I don't want to feel gross. Like, I want to... You know,
did you have your nails done? Because when my sister got engaged, we had to. She had.
I can't believe that. She's
she
like,
had
I,
bright yellow
seriously?
Nails, and my mom was like, "Those are hideous. You're not gonna want those." And my sister was like, "Why?
That's really
They're
funny.
Fine. Like, we're going on a trip. Who cares?"
You right.
know? My mom was like, "I would change your nails if I were you." And then so I think she kept them. And then in the engagement photos,
she'd Photoshop them. Yeah. No, I'm lucky. I've had the same French manicure for 10 years. Like, this is how my nails always are. So it was easy.
Was it like, hey, it's going to happen today? Or was it like, hey, we're going to go to the beach and we're going to take some photos?
No. So first of all, I kind of knew it was coming for the trip in general, because the trip that we did, it was our anniversary. And we go every summer to somewhere for our anniversary, which was like a resolution we made early on, because I was like, I'm really bad at leaving LA. I get really bad FOMO, or like fear I'm going to miss a business opportunity if I leave. And that's
so I have to do
bullshit
it.
Because the point of life is to live life, and I don't have to travel. So I was like, every anniversary, like every chance we have to go somewhere, let's just go. So we kind of alternate like a bigger trip, a smaller trip, a bigger trip, a smaller trip every year. And it was a bigger trip year. And we were like, what do we do? We couldn't figure it out. And like 10 days before, we were like, maybe we should go to Mexico. Like, where do we go? And then I remembered when 30 years ago, my parents went to Greece and they made a home video, like a really early home video talking to their future child. And my mother was not pregnant. Like, I was not even a thought yet, but my parents were like making this video for their future child. And I watched that video as a kid and I was like, I want to go to Greece. I want to go to Santorini. Mm-hmm. And my dad was like, wait till you find like your forever person. It's a really romantic trip, like go on a honeymoon or something one day. So I was trying to figure out where to go. And I was like, oh my God, we should go to Greece and go where my parents went 30 years ago. And then he and I went to my parents' house and we like rewatched the video with my parents, and they told us all their old stories, and we planned this trip to Greece in 10 days. So it's like, we're going to the island where my mom and dad went, where they
you
first got married.
You planned it in 10 days?
He planned the entire engagement. He planned the whole trip in 10 days. I was like, just here's the
oh,
money
so
I'm coming
he was
spending.
Not set on doing it. He was just like, he got the idea of like, we're
he
going,
had,
I have to do
well,
this now.
He had had the ring for like 6 months and he was going to propose in February at these beautiful botanical gardens in LA, and he had to cancel it because the shoot schedule of Thundermans changed. And then he rescheduled it for after Thundermans and he had to cancel it again because the schedule changed. And so when Thundermans
That's way
ended,
better, man.
Ended,
that worked
he was
out
just,
so well.
I know. When it ended, he was just basically waiting for like a good opportunity, because I'd always told him like, I want it to be somewhere that means something to us, and Greece meant something to us, even though we'd never been there. So in terms of actually knowing what it was going to happen, it actually came up because I was having a really bad mental health day while we were traveling. Cause like brain chemistry don't care about no vacation.
Yeah. No.
It just was one of those days where my brain was like, hey, what if you just wanted to die? Yeah. I was like, I'm literally with the love of my life on vacation right now. I don't have time for this.
Yeah, if you had that
you're
fumble,
in a 9-hour
I was on
time
a plane
difference.
With you,
and
I'd be
I brought
upset.
It up. I was like, I'm scared that you're gonna propose and I'm gonna ruin it all because my brain is being mean to me and like I'm terrified. And he was basically like, first of all, you can never ruin anything. Like, he just knows always exactly what to say when
as
I'm
as long
like,
as you're not on that Boeing
in that
7
yeah, with the door that
flew. Yeah, yep. Terrifying. Yeah. But I was like, can you just tell me like the 3-day window it's going to happen in so I can just like prepare myself? And he was like, it's going to be in Santorini. And we were only in Santorini for 3 days. So I knew, I was like, okay, one of these 3 days it's going to happen. So I just need to like pull myself together. And luckily by the time we were in Santorini, I was much better and I was having a great time and I had gotten over the jet lag and gotten some sleep and felt like a much better version of myself. And he said, we left the place at like 3:00, the hotel. And he was like, okay, we're leaving. And I was like, it's only 3:00. Like, you'd think it'd be sunset. I was like, is he going to propose at 3:00? He was like, the guy at the hotel desk told me that there's this like once in a year, once in a lifetime migration of African swallows over the caldera that we're going to go look at. And I was like, okay, we're going to go look at
That's
birds.
A great sentence.
That sounds great. I love birds. I love nature. And so we started walking towards the water. And then I was like, where are we going? Like the that's the water. Like, I guess we're just going to go stand down at the dock. But there was no dock. It was just a cliff. And I was like, where are we going?
He's
going
to kill you.
Yeah, he's going to kill me. And then I look over and there's like a private cliff, which used to be the hotel restaurant that had been cleared off, covered in rose petals with a guy playing guitar and the whole hotel staff and a photographer. And I was like, okay, I see what's all happening here. And we went down. And I think when he said, will you marry me? I replied with, so there's no birds.
Oh, God.
Because I was like, where are the birds? Oh,
God. And did you cry or no?
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah. I cried at first. And then I really cried because the hotel staff brought a card that our best friends had like written a handwritten letter to us. And then they brought me a drink of what we drank on our first date. And then I just like burst into tears because it was just very cute and thoughtful.
That's well done.
That's so classic though. Classic then, girlfriend, right? He's got this whole thing planned and she's going, we're leaving already. You didn't get the birds. It's like, guy's like, dude, I just played. We're on a cliff.
No,
man.
It
we're
was fabulous. Don't you make me sound like a bitch. I just was confused because I was like, where are we going at 3 o'clock? Like, we're not going to dinner. It turned out that it was because then at dinner time, that private cliff turns back into a restaurant and a table for two. And we went back and had a private, like, 15-course tasting meal dinner, just the two of us. And like,
oh, that's amazing.
It was cute. He'd also, the best touch, if you end up proposing and you're in a different time zone, so he had all of our best friends wake up at like 7 a.m. on a Sunday so that they would be awake when it happened. So I could FaceTime them all and they would all be awake because otherwise everybody would have been asleep.
Yeah, yeah.
So you did this thing?
So we went back. Yeah, we went to this. Yeah. We went back to the hotel room. And there were like roses and candles everywhere and everything. We FaceTimed all the friends and it's very cute. The ring is a whole story though. Did you see? Like I
think I saw your post about
this. Yeah, I had to send it to get resized.
And then
like,
it got lost.
Something went wrong. Yeah. They lost it or something happened. And I just like didn't know where my ring was and I didn't have it for like months. And everyone was like, you're engaged. Let me see. And I was like, I don't have it. Like I'm a fake fiance.
You get one of those surfing rings that you have. Like,
that's
silicone
what I did. Yeah? I got one of those little silicone rings just to have something to wear.
He must have been shitting his pants.
It was.
Calling
he
that
actually,
place. Just,
he actually wasn't.
He
doesn't really get stressed about anything. Like I felt really bad. I was really, really sad to not have it. And he was like, you know, like, it's going to be okay. Like, we will find it or we will get another. Like, it's going to be okay. And I was just like, no, I want my ring.
Oh, see, I'm the exact opposite. I'd have been like, dude,
my mind. Yeah.
You find me the ring tomorrow.
Well,
or
you know,
buying me one.
I felt really bad, but I did.
You're Italian. Really Italian.
I did end up posting and tagging the brand, which I've never done. Like, I never want to be a Karen, but I wasn't trying to like get them hate comments or like roast their business. I just wanted my ring back.
Yeah,
and I
get their attention. Hey,
get
guys.
In touch. And it worked. And as soon as I tagged them, they messaged me and they're like, we're so sorry. And they put someone on my case and they called
me. What ended up
and,
happening though?
I got a call from like the head of the customer service being like, I'm so, so sorry this happened. The woman who was handling your case no longer works with us, which either meant she got fired because of what happened, which if that's the case, I feel terrible. But also, or she left the company and that's why the ring file got lost. And that's what I think probably happened. It was probably in her computer and she left the company. And in those months where they were replacing her, fell through the cracks. Yeah. It was just locked in the shuffle. And it had been sent to their like vendor to change the diamond into a different setting. And they had it the whole time. It just wasn't in the system. The numbers weren't in the system. So when I would try to get a handle on where it was, they knew that they had it somewhere, but they couldn't get an answer on like what part of the process or when it's coming. It kept being like, oh, it'll be there soon. Oh, it'll be there soon.
Yeah.
And we were like about to leave for a trip. Like we were going to go sing. I was going to go sing at my cousin's wedding. I was like, I want my own ring when I'm like going to a wedding. Anyway, it all worked out. But it was
drop it off at an actual place?
No, we had to send it in the mail.
That's the scariest thing about it.
My thought would have been that it got lost in the mail.
Horrifying. Yeah, well, no, I did have confirmation that it arrived. Luckily, I had this random email that was like, your package has arrived in New Jersey or whatever. And I was like, okay, that must be the ring.
My home.
Saskatchewan.
Yeah,
Saskatchewan,
of course. That's crazy.
But I did, it was very stressful. And then it came back and it still needed to be smaller. And I was like, I'm so sorry. In the time I've been waiting to get the ring back, I have lost a couple pounds and it is nothing. Can I have it?
So, I'm not
and they
in
were very
anymore,
gracious
guys.
And normally they wouldn't do this, but they're like, yeah, no, considering like we'll make it small. So now it fits me. Have it.
So you guys want to be married for like 10 years before you have kids.
Yeah. Although it isn't even related to how long we're married. I think it's just that like I
place in your life.
Yeah. Like I want to travel a lot more before I have a screaming baby on a plane.
Yeah.
And like, I want to have a lot of patience.
I heard you can punch them on planes now if they're screaming.
Oh, really?
It's only legal in the air. Yeah.
If it's
because it's international waters, right?
Right.
It's just you can do whatever.
You can do whatever you want.
Yeah, yeah. Punch whoever. You can actually punch other passengers if you want.
That's
I mean,
like,
it's just
remember Louis had that bit where he was like, when you're on a plane and you hear a baby screaming, like, that's how selfish you are. You think that's happening to you.
Yeah.
He's like, you don't even know how the parent feels when that baby's crying.
Losing their eardrums. Yeah.
Yeah. I want to be...
You don't want that?
No, not yet. I want to be, like, the best possible version of myself before I'm having a human. And I could probably do a pretty good job right now, but, like...
That's the thing, is that, I mean, like, you could probably be better, but...
I just want to be selfish for a few more years.
Yeah.
Well, you're allowed to.
Yeah, exactly. There's no rush. There's plenty of time. And also, like, my mom had me at 35. My fiance's mom had him at 35. Like, that's what's always been modeled for me and just, like, makes sense. So I'm not...
My mom had me at 34, but she had had a kid at 24, I think.
Yeah, see, that's crazy. Like, I'm 26. Like, I could very well have...
But we all could have kids.
Yeah, we could have, if we hadn't had bizarre childhoods and
So many people I know from Indiana have kids
now.
I know.
A lot of, for me, it's like all the kids who came out to LA to do school during pilot season, and I would meet them at school and we would become friends, and then they would move back home. Like, they all have two or three kids now. Yeah.
My childhood best friend has a kid right now.
Really?
Bryce has a kid?
Probably. I don't know. Honestly, selfishly, the reason I really want to have a kid while I'm still young, I just want to be a hot young dad.
You want to be a DILF?
Oh, man.
I really badly. I think about it all the time. I never want to be...
All the time?
Dude, I
you
really
think about
do.
How badly you want to be a DILF?
Dude, do you remember when...
I want to be a hot...
Remember when you were
dad.
Like at like high school graduation or whatever it was, wherever you were, and you saw like somebody's dad for the first time and you're like, holy shit, that guy's old, you know? And you're like, I don't want to be that. Like, my dad was at my graduation and he's like fucking young, dude. You know, he's like a young...
I can't say I've had that experience.
I never want somebody to look at me and be like, you have that young of a kid? You know? You're fucking 80 and you got a 12-year-old?
Well, 80 is...
That's an old dad.
That's always been a concern of mine.
Yeah.
I didn't say it was a rational fear. I said it was my fear.
I do know, like, at least as a woman, I know the older you get, the
harder it is,
on your body. That part does scare me a little bit, but... I don't know.
Harder it is to actually get pregnant, too.
I think I'm having a fantasy right now, though, of being like a 50-year-old dad, and you're at
your fantasies are your business, dude.
Yeah, hold on, guys. Hold on. It's not DILF related. This is proper, all right? You go back to like a parent-teacher conference. Your kid got in trouble for doing something, clapping the erasers together and blinding a kid or something like that. I don't know. But you're
it still happens all the time with all those chalkboards.
With all those chalkboards, those electronic chalkboards. But you're in there, you're in the room, and you're like a 50-year-old dad, and there's this 30-year-old dad here with the kid that they had at like 16 or something. And you can just, you know, trump him with your wisdom and your authority. And that's a benefit to being an old dad. Then it's not like, you
superiority.
Know. Superiority, you know, more lives, more years on this earth.
Order condescending.
Yeah, exactly. I enjoy being condescending. I think
it's kind of cool though. I think my parents
are.
I could do that now.
Being condescending.
Yeah, you could just talk down.
Pretty damn good at it. My parents
just like that.
Have
good example.
Three grandkids before the age of 60. You know,
wow,
that's kind of crazy.
Being a young grandparent is definitely cool. I do feel bad because I know my parents are like excited to be grandparents.
Yeah,
because they had me so old. Relatively later, they're like, we want to have grandkids while we can still like pick them up and play with them. And I'm like, I would love for you to be a grandparent right now, except for that I am just not ready to have.
I think every parent wants to be a grandparent because it's the easier version
of being
a parent.
Oh, yeah, 100%. It's just like how I want my neighbor to have a dog, but I can't have a dog because I don't want to have to walk them and come home at 6 p.m. when I'm having a nice time with my friends at dinner. But I want to be able to cuddle your golden retriever every time I come home from work.
I want a dog.
My neighbor had a perfect golden retriever and she moved away and it was heartbreaking. Really?
I want a golden.
I love Goldens. I want one named Butterscotch, and I want one named Toffee, and then I want a Bernese Mountain Dog named Persimmon.
That's a lot of dogs.
Which one's the Bernese Mountain Dog?
Yeah, it'll be in like 15 years when I live in like a house with an acre of land.
And a five-year-old.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah, good luck with that. Dude, see, I'm so traditional, man. I just want like a house on some land with a golden retriever, a wife, and some kids.
And $100 million.
Yeah, $100 million would help a lot. It would make the property
a lot
better.
There's that part. I'm at the point. Ooh, sorry.
Yeah, just break this up.
I'm at the point now where truly I just want like I want a house with a garden, and I want to pick the flowers and use the flowers to make dye and dye the fabric and then sew clothes and then crochet my placemats and then do pottery and make all my ceramic dishware. And
I think there's an Amish community.
I know. I'm like, do I want to live in a commune?
What do you mean?
You lost me there for a second.
But no, it's just like all of my hobbies are becoming very tactile because I'm just so sick of screens and like my brain feeling like mush all the time that I just, this last year has been all about having like tactile hobbies for me. And it's just like, it's so much better than answering emails. Like, I don't want to answer an email. I just want to make a pot. Like, is that so wrong?
Yeah, sometimes you just want to make a pot.
I just want to smoke some pot.
Dude, I feel the same way, though, about, like, with, like, food. I really want to have property so that I can
grow.
Grow like
try to have some property so you can grow.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I would love to have like a greenhouse, and then I would love to have
a greenhouse.
Yeah. I want to own chickens. Can I get out my sentiment, please? I want to own some chickens. I would like to own some cows, and I want to know where my food is coming.
I have a question for you.
Yeah.
If you had chickens,
yeah,
my mom has chickens.
Nice. Huh? And you named them.
Yeah.
And you got attached to them. Could you then kill them and eat them? Because a few of my friends have had to do that, and it's an interesting
mind. I mean, I would not personally kill them.
You usually send them off somewhere.
Yeah, I would send them off. I would be okay to the great farm.
Do they send them off, or do they
butcher
them?
No, they processed them themselves.
Wow, that's...
Which I have a lot of respect for. I feel like if you're going to eat meat, being connected to it is a better way to do it.
You've heard the story of like everyone who's like, you know what? I raised the cow like after X amount of years of life.
I know it had a good life.
This is how I treated it. This is how I fed it. I spent time with it. I watched it have children.
Yeah.
Little
if you're going to eat meat, that's the way to do it, I guess.
Do you not eat meat?
I do. I have gone back and forth. I have been a carnivore. I have been a vegetarian. I have been a vegan. I have been
confused.
I've done keto. I've done everything. I'm torn about it all. These days, I eat in a way to be as healthy for my brain as possible, to be just as low stress, just feel connected to the food I'm eating and satisfied and healthy and give my body the fuel it needs. That's my priority right now. In the times where it's been more about the ethics, it's been easier to veer towards unhealthy eating territory. So right now I eat meat and it's great and I love it and it's delicious, but I can't think about it too much or I get really sad because I do love animals. I love cows. I love pigs, and there's no like humane way to kill an animal, but there are better ways than others. And and then there's also like, you think about the world, fake meat's a lot worse for the planet sometimes than real meat, depending on what the meat is.
Generally. You say grass-fed meat is actually worse for you and the environment.
Is it? Well, one cow.
How is it worse for you?
One hamburger is like a football field's worth of water or something crazy like that.
Yeah. I was listening to a podcast. I was Dax Shepard's podcast with...
That's generally where I get my information.
With an environmental scientist?
From podcasts or...
Dax Shepard.
I mean, the environmental scientist is obviously heralded as one of like the groundbreaking environmental scientists of this time. But he was talking about the impact on it on the environment, and I'll get the clip for you. But it's definitely harmful for the environment, like way worse.
Yeah,
but it's not like, apparently the grass fed is not that much better than grain fed based on the processes that go on in order for them to grow the grass and what goes into it. And like, I mean, nothing's actually organic.
I'm a firm believer in meat. I really am. Yep. I'm a big meat eater, and I feel like when I'm at my healthiest and feel mentally healthiest is when I'm eating a lot of meat. I think my problem with the way people perceive meat is like, I was listening to a podcast the other day, and they were saying how like when a doctor's like, hey, you should probably lay off red meat. And you look up like what the definition of like fat what though. They consider red meat to be is like, they can consider lasagna red meat because it has the meat in it. But nobody's going, well, what about the fact that you're eating like a shit meal and you're eating all these carbs and you're eating all this gluten and all this shit.
That's got tomatoes.
Why are we categorizing this as red meat? Whereas if you just ate a piece of red meat, it's not going to be the same as if you had a chunk of lasagna. That's the thing that I find stressful, that our definition of red meat is very strange.
Bradley cooks a steak once a day.
Easily.
Really?
Yeah.
Sometimes twice a day.
Wow. See, I don't cook meat because I'm scared of poisoning myself. So. Mm.
Well, meat's fine. Chicken, yeah. Chicken's scary.
Chicken is scary, my girlfriend and pork. I only eat meat if I'm out going out or if my roommate's cooking it for me.
Yeah.
which he does very often, which is nice.
Chicken and pork, those are very scary.
Yeah.
Fish.
I'll cook like sausages, like pre-made sausages, and I'll like squish them in the pan. And
Yeah. That one's pretty easy.
That's pretty easy, yeah.
It's hard to fuck that one up.
I'm like not scared I'm going to kill myself.
Steak, as long as the outside's cooked, that's where all the bacteria is.
Right, well, and it's ground is worse, I know, than regular.
Yeah, ground you got to cook all the
more dangerous. Guys, I do be cooking eggs, though. I love eggs. I eat so many eggs.
I do love eggs,
too. Eggs is what stopped me being vegan. My friend had chickens and gave us some eggs, and I just caved. And I had like a scrambled, like a super fluffy, soft scrambled eggs on toast. And I was like, "Oh, I forgot.
It's the best.
This is heaven."
Oh, and they taste way different. They're so much better. Farm fresh eggs are like, my mom goes out and gets her eggs from her chickens in the morning and cooks them 5 minutes
later.
That's
so fun. Where's your mom live?
Indiana.
Nice.
Yeah,
Alberta, Indiana.
Alberta, Indiana.
Hey, thank you for coming on.
Yeah. Thanks for having me.
That was a quick 50.
That went.
You know,
real
you said
quick.
You were.
Did we talk
shambles.
About anything of substance? Did we?
I think
that?
So.
I don't think so, but that's podcasting. So yeah. You think so? I don't think so.
What do you, really what do you consider substance?
That's bread meat.
Abuse?
Jesus. Let's not talk about abuse.
Substance abuse is what I'm saying. not abuse. What do you consider substance? Child abuse? Good.
Let's
one.
Not talk about child abuse.
Well,
let's be kosher. Let's end on a better note.
Personally, I think we did talk about substance. I do. I think that there's some stuff in there. We learned that you're from Saskatchewan.
Saskatchewan. Most importantly, we learned that I'm from Saskatchewan. Yes. Within 4 days, that's going to be input on my Wikipedia, along with all the other things that are wrong.
It probably
like
already
my
is
height and all of the people I've supposedly dated.
That what does it say your height is?
I don't remember, but it's wrong.
Mine said it's wrong. Mine says I'm 6'7". What?
Whatever. What about the people you dated? How wrong is that?
Very wrong. It says I dated Jack.
Yeah, well, that,
well,
that's...
Well, I mean... That happens did, with you know, any coasters. And we're going to perpetuate that misinformation
please
here.
Don't.
You heard it.
See, I'm in a bad situation with it now because now if I tell people I don't, people are like, doth protesteth too much. Yeah, and I'm like, I swear on
you heard
everything
it here first.
That is holy.
For sure. No, you didn't. I know.
She's definitely not dating Jack Griffo is what I'm hearing. But
she's getting
not
married just to like
well, my fiance's name is Max. You know this, right?
Jack's, which was Griffo. Jack's character, right?
Max?
Yeah, Jack's character.
No.
The character of
the
my brother.
The it's, character's name was Max.
It's really
exactly.
confusing.
Yeah,
it's
sure.
It's not good for the internet. The internet is not...
You're having a field day.
You would never have to worry about this, but could you imagine like dating somebody who has the same name as your sister?
Ooh.
I don't think you can do that, man.
That would. I literally have always thought I will never
or like
date
a
person. Oh, yeah. I don't know if I'm ever going to really come across a young girl named Kim at this point.
I know.
Neither will you. His mom's name is also Kim.
Really? Yes, two is, sons of Kim. You guys could start a cult.
Sons of Kim.
You can make a religion
sons
out of that.
Kim's
no, no.
Is the worst
that's a way
of
better
sons
podcast name.
Sons of Kim would have been a great podcast name.
Fuck you.
I get 20%.
That would have been so fun. Is it too late to change it? 10 episodes in?
No.
9 episodes
it's season
in?
2 is Sons of Kim. Right?
What would it
you
be?
You can add 20%.
Sons 21. Of Kim's?
Wow.
Yeah.
You're generous. You know? Thanks.
You're,
sons of
he's
Kim.
He's got to pay for a ring. So
I'm dealing with something here. Sons of Kim or Sons of Kim's?
I think Kim.
Son of a Kim.
Son of a Kim.
You son of a Kim.
You son of a Kim.
Ah, damn it, dude. That is so much
yeah,
better
so
than
much better.
See, you're
stupid
the one with the bad
name.
Timing now. You should have called me. 10 episodes ago.
God damn it, dude.
I know.
How did we never put that together?
I don't
this
know.
This is the
dude.
First
like,
time you've ever
dude,
consciously
like,
realized this?
Well, we knew our mom's name.
It was Kim, but son's Kim. Okay, but I gotta go. I gotta,
yeah.
I gotta go take
a nap.
I
actually have a friend named Kim that you should... I'm just kidding.
Yeah, great.
I won't
marry
set you up
her.
With any Kims.
Hey, thank you all.
Thank you again.
Hey, thank you.
I'm gonna pee my pants. I say that at the end of every episode,
you should
but I
go
really
pee
am about to pee my pants.
Elsewhere.
It's because you had 4 coffees. Okay. All right. I'm gonna pee. Thanks, everyone. Oh, he's gone now.
Bye.
Give it, dude, I can't even tell you. Right now, I'm cutting this podcast as Jake. And every fucking time that we cut in to an intro, outro, the episode, all I hear for the first 5 seconds is... and I'm so over cutting around that shit. And I'm so over hearing your goddamn deep guttural inhale. I gotta stop saying goddamn too, because I was trying to clip around that, and I can't. I can't. What a lovely guest she was, man. What a lovely... I had a great time. So many people, too. This is... I'm going to keep talking until Bradley comes back. So many people, too, were offering to do clips and stuff. And I might have to have him do it. Because the officer is so sweet. But
I felt myself about to do it.
Again? Or like when...
And I noticed it that time too. I was like, I gotta stop breathing.
It's so dumb too. We never say anything of substance. Every breath is just, like, so that was fun. We had a good time. Can we do this? A good time.
It's like,
because we're gonna go next week.
Why did it take
so
such
dumb.
A deep breath for nothing? Well, that's pretty cool.
Yeah. Oh, I liked her. Yeah. What a sweet lady.
Yeah, God. You know what I was going to say? Actually, it wasn't a substance, I guess, but I was going to say sometimes I feel bad when we have like Like, she comes into our studio. She looks nice. She's all dressed up. And I feel sometimes like we both wear hats. And I'm like
a shirt that says Krabby Jacks.
Like, should we try a little harder?
Dude? Hey, do I smell? I have pit stains. She's got a nice tank top and like the bootcut jeans. Hey, do I fucking smell to you? I'm covering my genitalia. It's just oozing. Sweat and odor. All right. It's the end of the episode. I think we've lost everyone by now, hopefully.
Just, nobody watches this show to the end, dude. Like, we can see the YouTube analytics.
Once they see two ads, they're like, why? What? Why would I sit here and wait for these guys
oh, God,
to talk
dude.
About red meat for
Fuck.
20 minutes?
Oh. Just sitting here with your eyes. Just, so yeah. What was it like working
so, Kira,
dick?
Can I ask you a question? I had so much coffee today.
Dude, what do you think? Right. These people leave, they're like, the fuck's up with those two guys, bro? They stink, they're heavy breathers. Just in the mic the whole time. Oh, these guys are disgusting.
I don't know if these guys are having asthma attacks on the podcast.
What's going
or
on? I actually was while she was talking at one point, I was thinking he's probably sitting me. He's sitting here just
sitting me. He's sitting on me.
This guy's sitting on me. What's he doing?
Stop sitting on me. Trying to do a pot.
Anyway.
We totally lost this outro, man.
It's been 5 minutes already. I was thinking he's just hearing me just.
Oh, someone was shot next door. I don't think I've ever laughed this much.
That was over a cannon, dude. I don't know.
It was a breath cannon.
You just loaded up so
I
hard.
I was trying not to laugh too. Bah.
All right. Well, that was a fun episode. Sorry, Kira, for ruining this entire outro. Oh, God. Wow.
Okay. Let me ask one question.
Oh, great. Yeah. Let's get to that.
That's what we dude came here for. I looked at.
Dude, what's going on next?
I don't know.
Full-fledged rave happening.
Kira's trying to get out, man. We should have let her out.
This is where we put our like, guests when they're done.
We're in the studio. There's another part. Let her out the door, and she's
not
trapped
I
anywhere.
To be back here. What is happening?
They're drumming. I looked for comments on Tara's video. Oh, this is. I don't even know if I said this already. We are actually. I think we're actually releasing for the first time in the same week that we filmed. This is what? Is there a gong over there? We filmed Tara's episode before Christmas. We released like 2 weeks later. This we released Tara's episode a few days ago, and now we actually get to release this one the following Monday. So it's updated.
That was disgusting. What, dude?
We gotta get out of here.
The problem is they're never gonna be able to hear what we're hearing over here. There's just cannons going off back here, dude.
That's where the Civil War reenactment takes place. Woo. Yeah. Okay, I know how to get us off a laugh. All right. no more giggles because of that joke. Hey, do you guys know? This is from Laura Jane Nolan. 2149. She was born in 2149. Do you ever?
Bag.
That's not even. God, let me get to it. Do you guys know of like any Scottish, English, or Irish comedians as well? She might be Scottish, English, or Irish.
Or Irish.
She's definitely
good
one of those
she's
three.
She's from the United Kingdom.
I know of a few English comedians.
Jimmy Carr,
Phil Wang. I want to have him on the show. I worked with him on the show I did in London. He's very funny. Jimmy Carr. He's fat and from Massachusetts.
Why'd you just call him fat?
I don't know.
Why did I guess she's not.
I saw him on stage after COVID, and he was like, "I did a lot of cocaine during COVID, and then I stopped
and got fat. And then he gained a bunch of weight. Fat?
Well, because he stopped doing cocaine. I guess he's not fat, but you know, he's not." Should I leave that one out? I don't know. I'm so exhausted from laughing for 10 minutes.
Can this just be our intro?
What?
Can this just be our intro?
No, impossible. This is from Sunset 1521. Is that this building's address?
yeah, great. Even if it is, why would you put it
I don't
out,
know.
Dude?
Hey, guys, love the podcast. Do you still hang out with the cast of your Disney shows? Why aren't you allowed to name the shows on the podcast? That, obviously, I don't think they understood that those were during the strike, so that's why we're allowed to name them.
Yeah, we've gotten asked that quite a few times, actually. Though any of the episodes that were released, the first two, I think, or three, I think Jack, two, Austin, and Kelly were all on strike.
Yep.
But now that that's over, we're allowed to talk about it.
Do you still hang out? Yeah, Bradley hangs out with Eric.
We saw Eric today.
Bridget lives in Maine.
I see you.
Yeah.
All the time.
God.
We see Paris.
See Kelly.
We see Kelly.
This is four questions.
Yeah, I think he would probably just accept
four
it,
questions.
Yes. Oh, okay.
Jake, why did you live with your Nana, not your parents? Because my parents live in Indiana and my Nana moved out here with me. Everyone calls her Nana. That's so insane to me. The whole world.
I think we refer to her as Nana all the time. Yeah.
Did your siblings also live with you or with your Nana? lived with my mom, actually.
Yeah, they didn't live with their Nana. They lived with yours.
And Bradley, have you ever considered trying new hairstyles?
Okay.
Have you ever considered trying? I've seen Jake with different ones, but I've only seen you with blonde highlights. Remember that? Was that college?
Oh, yeah. I had a buzz cut during COVID.
You did a... Did I buzz your hair? No, I fixed a buzz in your hair because Maddie buzzed it.
Somebody, or no, when I was living with you, I hadn't had a haircut in a long time. So we went to Target and bought shears and you shaved the sides.
The sides?
Yeah. And then trimmed the top a little bit.
Hmm.
Yeah. But I had a full buzz cut in the beginning of COVID.
You look good with the buzz cut. You can do that.
It depends. I have a pretty round face.
I think you had a rounder face. I think you'd probably look different.
I agree. I think we all know that. But
I like Brent Morin.
Brent Morin's not fat, dude.
Okay, dude, I'm not saying he's fat, okay? That's a mean word. I'm sorry, Brent. Let me just show you that.
He's not watching this show, dude.
No, I mean, but maybe his most loyal supporters are. Why can this just take just a little less time? He did not look like this at all. I'm telling you, he looked like... Let's see if I can find it.
Thankfully, you showed the camera.
I don't want the camera to see it.
We'll have little photos of Brent Morin pop up.
Us. Worse than that. That's a different human.
All right. Dude, why are we talking about this?
Just making a point, man. That he might, you know... He's a funny guy. He's not Irish or English.
I don't even know. The poor guy just got dragged through the mud for no reason.
The English comedian, Jack. What's his name? There you go. There's a Jack.
Who's Jack?
Who's Jack?
Who's Jack? I think we should probably end this podcast before you... You were disgusting, dude. You're just scratching your head right in the mic.
Well, I can do it right in the mic. I did it right above the mic. I don't think it picked it up. All right. Well, hey, thanks, guys, for tuning in. I drained myself of every piece of energy in my body. I got to get some water.
All right. Thank you for watching. Thank you, Kira.
Yeah.
I love you, buddy.
Love you, too. See you soon.
We got to do more, so no, I'll see you in a second.
Couple more.